Hey guys, Alex Rakin here, and today I'll be reviewing this Glary Gibb 5-string bass. Stay tuned.
Alright, so this is how the bass is shipped. It was actually incredibly light, and I soon discovered why, because it comes in styrofoam. I went ahead and opened the styrofoam, and the bass was wrapped in this thin styrofoam as well, with rubber bands. And here it is, in this sleek black color. So the bass came with this nice little bag here, woven cable, not bad for a $130 bass, and this strap with a pick. This is what the bag looks like. It's a thin bag, but what do you expect? Lastly, it came with these Allen keys to make any adjustments you need. Alright, let's take a closer look at this bass. The nice glossy black, really adjustable bridge here. You got some chrome hardware and knobs and all of that. This is what the neck looks like. Not bad, not bad. Alright, let's take a look at the back here. You have these enclosed tuners. Nice smooth maple neck. And you have some decent access with this heel over here. Chrome strap pins right there. And let's take a look over here. You have the back plate with the rear electronics.
Alright, so most of you guys know me as a guitar player. But I think every guitar player today should know how to play some bass in order to lay down bass lines on their music. And I'll be reviewing this bass from that perspective as a guitar player who would need to lay down some bass lines, essentially. So I'll let you guys know up front here that Glary did send me this bass to review, but I'm gonna give you my honest opinion. So considering its price point, this bass is actually pretty versatile and a pretty usable instrument. It features a basswood body, a maple neck, and a laurel wood fingerboard. On the headstock, we basically have closed machine tuners, and we have a plastic nut. This is a 34-inch scale bass, and it has 24 frets, and in this case, 5 strings. It also comes in 6 and 4. This bridge looks very sturdy and is very adjustable, and the access is great to the last frets if you're gonna go that high. The electronics here are actually very versatile, so you have 2 volume knobs, one for each humbucker, and then you have 3 tone knobs set to 3 different frequencies so that you can dial in just that perfect tone. As I showed you earlier in the video, they did include this strap, this pick, and even this red cable right here, which is woven. Kind of a nice touch. So I have the bass just going direct into the interface right now, going through the Parallax plugin by Neural DSP. And I'll just fool around on it a little bit, let you guys hear what the sounds like. Let's check out the bridge pickup alone by turning down the neck pickup. Now just the neck pickup. Having both pickups up, here's what it sounds like if I cut the first tone. And the second tone as well. And the third tone as well. I'm gonna go through that again, but now with the pick. All knobs up. Bridge only. Neck only. Bridge and neck, first tone down. Bridge and neck, 2 tone knobs down. And all 3 knobs down. All 3 tones down. Maybe we'll try this middle tone knob up. So there's a lot of tonal variability here, and I'm sure you can dial in the sound that's just right for you. My first impressions with this bass were that it's obviously not a premium level instrument. There are cosmetic flaws as you just kind of look through the little details on the bass. But this bass isn't meant to be aesthetically perfect. It's basically meant to be a functional workhorse that can get all kinds of different sounds and just be everything you need it to be for whatever situation that you're in. I currently only have a 4-string bass, so it's nice that this 5-string goes down to that low B so I can really play along an octave lower with the 7-string stuff that I play. If you're looking to get a bass for your studio, or if you're looking to just actually get into playing as a beginner, or get someone a bass as a gift to start to learn, this is actually a great place to start, because these basses are inexpensive, and then if you ding it or something like that, you won't feel so bad about it. And you can play this on through, let's say, an intermediate level, and it's quite playable. You can adjust it, so if you want lower action, you can do that as well. You can get some different strings if you would like. And all in all, I would say that this is pretty great bass for the money. If you guys have any questions about this bass, you can go ahead and leave them in the comments below. All right, guys, if you dug this video, go ahead and smash that like button. Comment below because it really helps this channel grow. Join the tribe, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. And I'll see you guys in the next one.